Hey, Brian Miller here, and thanks so much for tuning into Thursday Thoughts on the One New Person podcast. This is an experimental new segment we've only done a few times, and I'd love to know if you're enjoying it, if you're finding it valuable. We're doing it every other Thursday on the off weeks from our long-form interviews. That is the typical content we do on this podcast. So hit me up at onenewpersonpodcast@gmail.com or anywhere on social media at bmillermagic, and let me know, are you enjoying these short Thursday Thoughts segments, these little solo podcasts in between our regular interviews. Today's episode is called Inside Out and Upside Down. In 1961, the Museum of Modern Art in New York City put a new exhibition on display entitled The Last Works of Matisse. Among the pieces in this exhibition was a paper-cut abstract of a sailboat and its reflection, entitled Le Bateau, which, apart from being a member of the Last Works of Matisse, was somewhat unremarkable. Except someone did remark upon it. The museum got a call from a Wall Street stockbroker named Genevieve Hebert, who claimed the piece was upside down. The museum pushed back, of course. How could you tell? What are you talking about? Who even are you? She insisted Matisse never would have put the less complex motif on the top and the more complex on the bottom. The piece is upside down. And sure enough, she was right. 47 days and 100,000 visitors, no one else had noticed. I made a similar mistake last year on tour, but no one caught me, so this is kind of my confession. See, it was the beginning of the fall back-to-school tour, which is what I call in August and September every year. I bounce around colleges and universities all over the U.S. doing an inspirational talk for mostly incoming freshmen, occasionally incoming grad students, on the true purpose of college. That, in fact, the purpose of college is not to get your piece of paper at the end of the road, but in fact, to learn to weave a network of people who trust you, to learn to show up for the people in your lives with empathy and generosity on a regular basis. And that, in fact, is the path to success. So anyway, I was getting ready for this tour and I thought, well, let me pick up a few new pocket silks to kind of spice up my wardrobe and my blazers. And this one particular pocket silk really caught my eye. It was a beautiful, beautiful blue silk with vertical ribbons, blue, white, and lighter blue running up and down it. It's really, really something to see. It feels nice. It's silky. And then one day in the green room, getting ready to go on stage, I realized I had made a horrible error. In fact, I had been wearing this pocket silk inside out. It was actually a fairly normal, quite banal navy blue silk with polka dots. Not nearly as exciting, but it made me embarrassed. I had been wearing this backwards for months at that point. I couldn't believe it. And then it occurred to me, so often, it's seeing something from a different perspective that allows us to really appreciate the beauty in it. This is true of art, of course, but also of relationships, which are a kind of art in their complexity and subjectivity. It's often seeing something from a new angle, from a different perspective, that allows us to really see it for what it is and appreciate the beauty fully. This is also true of our jobs, which even the most exciting job, like, hey, corporate magician, when I used to do that, can become fairly rote and dull on a day-to-day, moment-to-moment basis. If the museum had never hung Le Bateau upside down, I likely never would have heard of it, and I'm guessing neither would you. Instead, it's become one of my favorite pieces of art. I'm totally and completely captivated by it. And so I will continue to wear this pocket silk inside out, and hey, maybe even upside down. And who's to say that's wrong? That's it for this week of Thursday Thoughts on the One New Person podcast. Thanks so much for tuning in. My name is Brian Miller. This is One New Person, and we'll see you on Monday with a new interview.